Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Roberto Araujo!
Singing with my heart, 'cause my eyes can see you now right by my side. 'Cause you blessed me with your laughter, because now we found each other. And beside you there is nothing I can't do. Canta corazón, que el amor de mis amores ya está aquí. Que guardado en cada carta, que escribí con las palabras, que sembraste en cada beso que te di. Con el tiempo te pensaba aferrada a mis manos, y con la lluvia consolaba tu ausencia en los años. Y con el tiempo yo sabía que algún día morirías por volver. Te lo dije cantando, ay, te lo dije de frente, y que volverías con written in the stars. We were meant to be together, nothing else can come between us. And beside you all my dreams seem like they finally come true. Y con el tiempo te pensaba aferrada a mis manos, y con la lluvia consolaba tu ausencia en los años. Y con el tiempo yo sabía que algún día morirías por volver. Te lo dije cantando,
as if I play a part. Now I see, if I wear a mask, I can fool the world, but I cannot fool my heart. See me, feel me, touch me. Me. So now that you've arrived, well, you wonder, what is it that I've done to make the grade? And should I do the same? Is that too easy? Am I only trying to please them? I'm desperate to deliver anything that could give me a sense of reassurance when I look in the mirror. Look at your face in the mirror. I am there inside. I won't pretend that I'm someone else for all time. When will my reflection show who I am inside? Cuando en mi reflejo yo me veré en verdad.
Good evening, everyone. So nice to see you. Welcome to the Green Room 42. I'm very happy to be here tonight. And before anything else happens, let me introduce myself. My name is Roberto Araujo, not Rafael. It's like Robert with an O at the end. I'm gonna help you out. Roberto. Yeah, or you can call me Bobby, lots of my friends do. So tonight, I'm gonna share a little bit of who I am and where I come from. I've been very lucky to wear many different hats throughout my life. Some of you know me from my acting career in shows like In the Heights or West Side Story. Some people know me as a photographer, and I see lots of familiar faces that I've photographed out there. And some people here also know me as a sales rep for Broadway ticket sales, saying things like, no, sir, there's no show called The Bandit's Visit. No. And more recently, as the video content manager for Playbill. Yeah. Heard of them? All right, so this origin story starts like every good origin story does, with a catchy theme song.
Most effectual top cat, whose intellectual close friends get to call him TC, providing it's with dignity. Top cat, the indisputable leader of the gang. He's the boss, he's a bit, he's a championship, he's the most tip top. He's a king, but above everything, he's the most tip-top.
So, I grew up in Mexico City, the youngest of five, mostly watching cartoons dubbed into Spanish. And I'm not sure if you're familiar with my favorite, Top Cat, or Don Gato. That's a cartoon from the 50s, and it was huge in Mexico through the 80s. That catchy tune convinced me that I was in love with New York City. I've got beginner's luck. The first time that I'm in love with you. Gosh, I'm lucky, I've got beginner's luck. There never was such a smile or such eyes of blue. Gosh, I'm fortunate. So New York City, that's where I saw myself. Every time I saw the skyline in magazines or movies, I could see myself there. And then I found a new love. theater, musical theater. My high school was holding auditions for a Spanish production of Guys and Dolls. I auditioned and I booked the gig, and the rest is history.
Suerte esa noche vendrás, sé que me acompañarás. Suerte si es que tú me ayudas esta noche, suerte una dama serás. No vamos a discutir, no te me vayas a ir. Quédate, nena, soy el chico que te trajo, sé una dama por mí. This thing we've begun is much more than a pastime, for this time is the one when the first time is the last time. I've got beginner's luck, lucky through and through. For the first time that I'm in love with you.
I was part of the Thomas Jefferson Musical Theater Company, and before I knew it, I had been in every show they had done. But believe me, they were not Broadway, but it certainly felt like it. And then when I thought I had it all figured out, I went to a wedding with my family, and there was this guy across the room, and he was looking at me, and he smiled and called me over, and he said to me, I think you are very handsome.
Ayer jamás me enamoré, pero llegaste tú y no te dejaré. Ayer jamás me enamoré, guardé mi corazón, pues siempre te esperé. Pero llegó a mí esta emoción y brota una canción que no puedo callar. Pido perdón, no lo puedo explicar. Jamás creí llegar a amar así. Begun is much more than a pastime, for this time is the one when the first time is the last time. I've got beginner's luck, lucky through and through. For the first time that I'm in love, the very first time that I'm in love, the first time that I'm in love with you.
Oh, the first love. So intense and so unconditional and so short-lived. I was so focused on my newfound theater life that that relationship didn't really last very long. Maybe you know this, maybe you don't, but Mexican mothers are very involved in their children's lives. So my mother found a letter, yes, a letter, a handwritten letter, that a boyfriend had given me. And she gave me the whole speech about me going to hell for being gay, and also she was not crazy about me doing theater. So for the next year, for about the next year, the relationship between my mom and my sisters went a little bit like this. Would you be able to take me to rehearsals, por favor? Okay, well, would you be able to pick me up from rehearsals? Well, how about some privacy? Everybody says don't, everybody says don't, everybody says don't, it isn't right, don't, it isn't nice. Everybody says don't, everybody says don't, everybody says don't walk on the grass, don't disturb the peace, don't skate on the ice. What I say, do I say? grass he was meant to feel. I say sail, tilt to the windmill, and if you fail, you fail. Everybody says don't, everybody says can't, everybody says wait around for miracles. That's the way the world is made. I insist on miracles, if you do them. Miracles, nothing to them. I say don't, don't be afraid. I felt very lonely and rejected. And you know what helped me? Listening to my Broadway cast recordings and watching the Tony Awards and learning every song and every choreography. I think my family had a really difficult time understanding how this kid could spend hours on end watching a VHS tape of Bernadette Peters in Into the Woods. The gay thing, the theater thing, my mother could not handle it for much longer, and one day she said to me, Roberto, tienes 24 horas para salir de esta casa. Yes, she gave me 24 hours to leave her house. And that's when I realized that's not where I was supposed to be. There's gotta be something better than this. There's gotta be something better to do. And when I find me something better to do, I'm gonna get up, I'm gonna get out, I'm gonna get out and do it. There's gotta be some respectable trade. There's gotta be something easy to learn. And when I find me something I have with can learn, I'm gonna get up, I'm gonna get out, I'm gonna get out and do it. There's gotta be some life cleaner than this. There's gotta be something easy to learn. And when I find me some kind of life I can live, I'm gonna get up, I'm gonna get out, I'm gonna get up, get out, and live.
That tells me how I live and die. So what did I do? I packed my things and I left everything behind, just like that. September of 2000, I moved to New York City without knowing anyone, without a place to live. I arrived just to realize that the New York of my dreams was not so ideal. I slept out on the street. I slept out on the street for two nights. I was here, alone. Follow the wind song, follow the thunder, follow the neon in young lovers' eyes. Down to the gutter, up to the glitter, into the city where the truth lies. Looking around me, what can I see? Anger and hope and doubt. What am I all about? And where am I going? You tell.
So here I was in New York City, ready to throw in the towel. And I remember my friend Monica back in Mexico, she said to me, Beto, you made an adult decision with adult consequences. You're gonna stay out there and stick it out. So I did. I joined the choir at Jesus Community College, where the choir director, Mrs. Shankman, she took me under her wing and she taught me how to write my resume and she gave me a backstage to look for auditions. My friend Link and my friend Marilyn opened their homes to me so I could stay with them until I got on my feet. Shortly after that, by October, I was much better. And I remember I went to a Halloween party and I met this guy, Jeff from Ohio. And he was so handsome and he showed interest in me. And so we went out on a couple of dates. And I remember he used to say, God, I love your accent. And I was like, what accent? So I was looking for a place to live, and Jeff asked me if I would move in with him so we could split the rent, and it sounded like a great idea at the time. And I was so excited, I went to EC Everything. Do you remember EC Everything? It was a massive internet cafe that was right here on 42nd Street, next door to the New Amsterdam. I think the McDonald's is there now. So I went to this massive internet cafe to email my friend Monica back at home. Querida Monica, I know you'll think I'm potty, but this time I really found him. Jeff is what they called Midwestern. How to tell you what that means? He's open, optimistic, and makes everything seem easy. And what he likes to wear are bright red cowboy boots and jeans. There are lots of things I miss here. No one makes a normal sandwich. You need Goliath's mouth to go and get through one of them. I don't know how to say this, but American men are different. They seem at first quite normal, but I really fear they're not. They're all buzzy and electric and so proud to be neurotic. And the thought of growing older seems to bother them a lot. And then things started to change with Jeff. So my first boyfriend in New York and now my roommate went from thinking that my accent was so cute to saying things like, I can't understand what the fuck you're saying with that accent. So all of a sudden I was hesitant about everything about me, the way I looked, the way I sounded. Did I really sound that foreign? A couple of months later, I booked a tour. I went on tour to Germany and Austria with the show The Best of Andrew Lloyd Webber and more. Much more. The show wasn't great, but I have to say that I met some of my dearest friends during that tour. So we were flying back from Germany, and we flew into JFK Airport, and we're about to go through immigration when my friend Tim said to me, hey Bobby, where are you going? So I explained to him that as a non-US citizen, I had to go through a different line for immigration. And he looked a little confused, but then he explained to me that he never thought of me as foreign. He saw me as his friend, and he loved me and accepted me the way I looked and the way I sounded. And that small gesture gave me the confidence to come back to New York to confront Jeff and move on without the baggage of his own insecurities and ego. And did I mention? He was an actor. Sex with an actor. What was I thinking? I feel like such a fool. Sex with an actor. What was I dreaming? That made me break that rule.
Why wasn't I onto his 8x10 smile? Why wasn't I onto his well-rounded tones? Why didn't I have on my actor deflector before I decided to jump his bones? And now I'm here under much duress with a Broadway musical actor, no less, with some direction. I think I've sent him, and now we're finally there. But then the talent breaks the momentum to readjust his hair. And as we reposition and reposition and reposition and reposition, I realize for all of his special effects, he's not really having sex, but doing an audition. Lights, camera, action. He's finally coming as passion takes his flight. But then with horror, I hear him humming the music of the night. Applause, applause. Your star never shone so bright. Now take a bow and exit right. Sex with an actor. I'm so glad I could attend. The end.
Crazy, crazy. In May of 2003, I booked another gig that's gonna take me away from New York for a little bit. This time I'm going on board a cruise ship, and I'm gonna be the lead singer in the show Fiesta Latina. And that was the first time they actually hired a Latino performer to sing that part, which blows my mind, but anyway. So I'm on the ship and I'm having a great time, but I have to say, those insecurities still come back and haunt me. And it doesn't help that I keep running into casual racism. You know, things like, do Mexican people wear modern clothes? Or, my friend told me never to go to Mexico City because I'm gonna get murdered because I look too much of a gringa. Oh, and my favorite, this guy I was working for looked at me in the eye and he said, Bobby, if I would have known you're Mexican, I wouldn't have hired you. When you fall asleep, what do your eyes see? Nothing. When you fall asleep, what do I see? Something. No, not many sheep. An image of a man is calling out to me. Suddenly, do you even dream? Is everything like real life when you dream? What does your dream world sound like? Como hablar en tus sueños? How did you do that? How did I do that? I don't mean to sound super offensive. It's what comes before offensive stuff. No quisiera sonar muy ofensivo. I'm like, what? Do you dream in Spanish? They ask, do you dream in Spanish? I'm like, I don't know. Sueñas en español, sueñas en español, like, oh. Sometimes, sometimes, sometimes people say to me, hey, Rodrigo, do you think in English or in Spanish? And I'm like, it's not Rodrigo. And I have to stop and think about this. Spanish can be a very passionate language. When you live in two different worlds, which of the two is my language?
To continue in English, press 1. Para continuar en español, presione 2.
Now look at me, here I am now thriving. Oh, so suddenly I feel like inviting people to see the realest of me. Ay, Dios mío. If you laugh, then my joke is not offensive. It's not true, sometimes I'm just polite. I'll go home and go to sleep thinking tomorrow is another day. Will I dream in Spanish? They ask, sueñas en español? Like, I don't know. And that's fine. It's sort of like a game. That's fine. No two dreams are the same. And that's fine. So I'm on the ship, right? And I'm having a great time, and I'm getting to travel, and I'm getting to work with people from all over the world. And then there was this one Australian dancer. Brett. Listen, after all the things I had been through at that point, I was not looking to date immediately. But I have to say that I started hanging out with Brett, and this Australian man stole my heart. He taught me a lot about myself, and I think together we figured out how to make things work, even when we're far away from each other. Other side of Eden, my heart had been waiting for your presence. Who knew we were perfect for each other? We were two lonely souls of different tongues, till we made our love together. Oceans keep the distance in between us, but nothing can keep us separated. No corner of the earth is out of reach. I will go anywhere and pay any price just to hold you close to me. My love is yours. My love is yours, baby. My love is yours till time expires. Forever is a frightening idea, but you helped me conquer any fear. These years have passed the test of time, and it's a beautiful start to where we belong, sharing in each other's lives. My love is yours. But our love forever will grow. Well,
And when was this? In 2009, I went back on tour. This time I'm going to China with the show Fame. And actually, this is a little reunion. Alex, our trombone player, was with me in that tour. Yep, we survived. So we are going to China, and before I go to China, on my birthday, Brett surprised me with my first DSLR camera. DSLR means digital single lens reflex. Super nerdy. And listen, I've always been interested in the visual arts way before we all had cameras in our pockets and Instagram filters. And this camera, combined with the tour, really changed the way I looked at the world around me. It starts with a light. It's like you wouldn't even know which way to look until the sun shows you a line, shows you a corner, builds you a frame. And once there's a frame, then you can see the world. Here's the world through a small window. You thought it was a bridge. You thought it was the water. You thought it was the sky. It's the world inside a frame. And you wait. And you wait. And you wait. And you, right there, something shifted, something. That tree threw a shadow, did you? There. It's like all you didn't know that you were waiting for is just outside the frame. And it can change the way. Here's the world in a box forever. Go stand over there. Don't look at me. Now, look at me. Look at me. There. There. Here's the world. Here's the world in a box forever. November of 2017, I woke up seeing that. I woke up with double vision. I didn't know what it was. 3 days later, my left eye was almost completely shot. It was very scary. I went to the doctor, and they told me go to the emergency room immediately. I started doing tests, and it was 3 months before I found out what it was. During those 3 months, I lost strength in my arms and legs to the point where I couldn't hold my camera throughout a photo shoot. So now not only my vision is being altered, but also I can't even hold the camera. Not to mention the way I look. I have people saying to me, "Girl, you look like you're about to fall asleep." Three months later, I found out that I have an autoimmune disease called myasthenia gravis. It affects the communication between nerves and muscles. I'm much better now, and it's something that I still deal with and manage. And this time, in this difficult situation, I was not alone. I had Brett, and I have a wonderful family of friends. And I want to invite a couple of people to sing with me tonight, the people who were there for me throughout all this process and that helped me come out of it. So first of all, I want to invite Nathan Cockcroft to the stage. Please welcome him with a big round of applause.
You got me crying. That was rude.
Hi. Sorry. How are you, Nathan?
I'm good. How are you?
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
So Nathan and I have been friends for a few years now. Mm-hmm. And it happens that we have so many things in common.
Definitely. We're both performers.
We're both performers. Mm-hmm. We both work on cruise ships.
We both found our husbands on cruise ships.
Good point. Good point. So we're basically twins.
Like literally twins.
Wait a minute. Is this our sideshow moment?
I think it is, Bobby. Yeah. I think it is, definitely. Yeah. Yeah. Is it?
I'd rather be sailing, yes, I would, on an open sea. I'd stand at the railing if I could, feeling wild and free. The sun is on my neck, the wind is in my face, the water's incredibly blue. Go sail and then come home to you.
Hey, I love you. Set those sails. A good man never fails.
I'd rather be sailing.
Hey, I love you. Set those sails. A good man. Me close your eyes. I am living proof a coward still can rise. You might tell me you're a victim, you might get what you deserve, but I won't excuse, no, I can't excuse a boy who's lost his nerve.
Sex is good, but I'd rather be sailing.
Set those sails.
Food is nice, but I'd rather be sailing.
On an open sea.
People are swell, but I'd rather be sailing.
I love you over the horizon.
I'd rather be sailing.
A good man never fails. be sailing, yes, I wanna go sail. And then come home to you.
Hey, I love you, set those sails.
Thank you, Nathan. Yay! You can just leave it there. Or take it with you. Yes. Great. Great. So when I was putting together this show, I ran into my friend Michael, and he was so kind to lend his talents to help me with the show and to help me write the title song of the show, Do You Dream in Spanish? And tonight he's here with me, and I would like to invite him to the stage, Michael Perry Jr. Please welcome him with a big round of applause.
Hey.
Oh, you came with your mic.
Great. I know, I brought the mic with me.
Hi. Give me a hug. You were gone for so long.
I was.
Welcome back. What were you doing? Now?
I was touring. I did 3 national tours back to back.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah. Well, welcome back.
Thank you.
People ask me all the time how, yes, like, how was it that you captured such a great, the essence of what I, like, my experience in Do You Dream in Spanish?
Well, we talked a lot.
We talked a lot.
And then we talked more than that. And then we sat around and drank wine. And then also, I was born and raised in Mexico as well.
Shut up.
No. But no. It was a lot of talking, a lot of discussion, I really got to know who you were, and I wanted to write a song with you that, you know, exemplified that.
So, from our conversations?
Yeah, it was back and forth, the dialogue.
So, anything that I would have said would have made it into the song?
Absolutely, like so that.
So if I would have said this, that would have made it into the song?
That would have been the first lyric.
Wait, and what if I said this?
Yeah.
What if I said, I love my kitty cat?
That would have definitely made it into the song, yeah, for sure. Yeah. You know, what if this dialogue were set to music? What if what we're saying could be said in a song?
Hey, that's not a bad idea, perhaps we could use it. Music in a musical, how can we go wrong? We could ask significant questions. We could get important points across, like, are we writing for art?
Yes, and is art a springboard for fame?
And will fame get folks to trust us?
Or will they trust us if it's just us, me and you? To nobody's in New York.
Hey, I think it's working, we're discovering choices. Lots of things to talk about when writing a show.
It's creating a vehicle to showcase our voices. And I don't mean our vocal cords, I mean what's below.
Uh-huh.
We could ask significant questions. We could get important points across, like, are we writing for art?
Yes, and is art a springboard for fame?
And will fame get us a paycheck?
But will a paycheck mean that we're sellouts? And if we sell out, will they yell out me and you to nobody's in New York?
Key change. Someday our show will get a theater, and if not this festival, then somewhere out west.
TV actors in the show, what could be better?
Sweeter. The lyric is sweeter.
Wait, what?
You know that, because we wrote it. It's, you always say better, and the lyric is sweeter.
Yeah, but here's the thing. One sounds like it's 2 syllables, the other one sounds like it's 3 syllables, so it's like sweeter, theater. Does that rhyme?
Yes. Logan from the Key Changer. 5, 6, 7, 8. Maybe someday our show will get a theater, and if not this festival, then somewhere out west.
TV actors in this show, what could be sweeter? We can get that Goomin was an empty nest.
Yes, Dina Manoff. Yeah,
she's awesome.
She is awesome.
She was in Greece.
Yes,
and leader of the pack. We could ask significant questions. We could get
get important points across. Like, are we writing for art?
Yes.
And is art a springboard for fame? And will fame get us a sitcom? And will a sitcom get us on Ellen? And will Ellen get folks to like us? And if they like us, will they mic us, me and you? To Nobody's in New York.
Please giving a big round of applause once again, Michael Perry Jr. and Nathan Cockcroft. Welcome, Brass. Welcome back. We missed you. Talk amongst yourselves.
Music, I got my man. Who could ask for anything more? I've got daisies in green pastures. Well, I've got plenty or nothing. Who could ask for anything more? Old man trouble, I don't mind him. You won't find him round my door. I've got starlight, I've got sweet dreams. I got my man. Who could ask for anything more? Who could ask for anything more? Days can be sunny with never a sigh. Don't need what money can buy. Birds in the trees sing their day full of song. Why shouldn't we sing along? I'm a cheaper all the day, happy with my lot. How did I get that way? Look at what I've got. I've got rhythm, I've got music, I've got my man. Who could ask for anything more? I've got DYDIS in green pastures. I've got my man. Who could ask for anything more? Old man trouble, I don't mind him. You won't find him hanging round my front back door.
A little after a year of dating Brett, I decided to pop the question. And so I remember we were in Cozumel, Mexico, and we went out for dinner and some drinks, and then I just did it. And he said no. He wasn't ready, and looking back at things, I don't think I was either. But he kept the ring, and it was 5 years later when he said yes, and we finally got married February 2017. So here we are.
Yeah.
bésame mucho. Como si fuera esta noche la última vez. Bésame, bésame mucho. Que tengo miedo a perderte, perderte después. Oh, 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 bésame, bésame mucho. Each time I cling to your kiss, I hear music divine. Bésame, bésame mucho. Hold me, my darling, and tell me you'll always be mine. Quiero tenerte muy cerca, mirarme en tus ojos, verte junto a mí. Piensa que tal vez mañana yo ya estaré lejos, muy lejos de aquí. Bésame, bésame mucho. Como si fuera esta noche la última vez. Bésame, bésame mucho. Que tengo miedo a perderte, perderte después.
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for this amazing band. We have Zach on the sax, Kurt on the trumpet, Alex on the trombone, Pito on the guitar, Zachary on the drums, Sean on the bass, and our musical director and the piano, Logan Colwell Block.
Quiero tenerte muy cerca, mirarme en tus ojos, verte junto a mí. Piensa que tal vez mañana yo ya estaré lejos, muy lejos de aquí. Bésame, bésame mucho. Como si fuera esta noche la última vez. Bésame, perderte después. Que tengo miedo a perderte, perderte, perderte después.
So you might be wondering, whatever happened to my family? And have I talked to them? Do we see each other? That answer is not short. And the Green Room 42 sets a time limit for the shows. So here is the short answer to that. A couple of years ago, my parents came to visit for the first time in the 19 years that I've lived in New York. And it was great. Brett was here, so we got time together, and we got to show them our home and our friends and the family that we've chosen to support us here in New York. And one night, we went out for dinner, and my mom got really quiet. And she said to me, "Roberto, parents make mistakes, and parents learn from their mistakes. We love you, and we love Brett." So here I am, a gay man, an immigrant, a performer, videographer, photographer, with my asthenia gravis, who is surrounded by a family of friends. And they give me their support, and that really, it's a New York story. Not exactly Top Cat, but definitely a New York story, and that's why New York will always be my home, and that's what I love, New York City. One of the things that I've learned about this whole adventure is that we all have dreams and aspirations. And what language are yours in? At the end of the day, it doesn't matter. Last night I went and stood outside the house that I grew up in. Been so long since I was there, I had to go and see. And I wondered on the highway what the house would look and feel like. Would it be my memory? Wasn't easy at the house that I grew up in, but I wouldn't be the man I am if life were perfect then. After all the years, and after all of my addresses, was I coming home again? Was I coming home? There were the bricks, I watched them lay along the driveway. I helped my father plant that tree a million years ago. It may just be the photographs or all that I remember. Very hard to know. The sliding pond, the station wagon parked out front, the backyards where we played. And suddenly I realized I'm older than my parents were the day we moved away. Shouldn't be there.
Someone had a light on in my room. Someone had a light on in my room. So good. I'm a stranger now in my neighborhood. I've seen the world at a faster pace, and I'm coming now from a different place. Though I may look the same way to you, underneath there is somebody new. I am not the boy next door. I don't belong like I did before. Nothing ever seems like it used to be. You can have your dreams, but you can't have me. Oh, I can't go back there anymore, 'cause I am not the boy next door. You've been saving those souvenirs, faded photographs of my foolish years. You've made plans, but they're wearing thin, and they won't work out, 'cause I don't fit in. And those memories, they just weigh you down, 'cause I've got no place to keep them uptown. I am not the boy next door. I don't belong like I did before. Nothing ever seems like it used to be. You can have your dreams, but it can't have me. Oh, I can't go back there anymore, 'cause I am not the boy next door. I'm not sorry for just being me, but when you look past the past, you can see that I am not the boy next door. I don't belong like I did before. Nothing ever seems like it used to be. You can have your dreams, nobody can have me. I can't go back there anymore, 'cause I am not, I am not, I am not the boy next door.
Shall we go for it? Let's do it. It's no good. It's too pat. I can't just play a final song, say so long and leave it at that. It's all right. I've got time. So I didn't hitch a ride on a rocket to the top. I'll get there in a steady climb. What did it mean? What have I learned? Crossing bridges before they're burned. Leading life instead of being led. Using my head, what's it about? Did I lose innocence going in or gain experience coming out? What did it mean? What have I learned? Eating off tables before their turn. Leaving up and flying out of bed. Driving a pen, taking the wheel, driving again, throwing down the pencil and running in ink. This is how I feel, this is what I think. Dreaming again and making those dreams real.
I stride. If I'm not breaking the ribbon at the end of the race, it's only cause I haven't tried. What did it mean? What have I learned? Taking the credit I know I've earned. Waking up and flying out of bed. Throwing down the pencil and grabbing a pen. Taking the wheel, driving again. Throwing down the pencil and writing in ink. This is how I feel. This is what I think. Dreaming again and making those dreams real. Taking the wheel. I've been in the backseat long enough, tagging along for the ride. I've been in the backseat long enough to know that you never get what you deserve if you never can decide. There's only one way to get where you wanna go. Throwing down the pencil and grabbing a pen. Taking the wheel, driving again. Throwing down the pencil and writing in ink. This is how I feel. This is what I think. Dreaming again and making those dreams real. Taking the long enough, tagging along for the ride. I've been in the backseat long enough to know that you never get what you deserve if you never get the side. There's only one way to get where you wanna go. Throwing down the pencil and grabbing a pen. Taking the wheel, driving again. Throwing down the pencil and running.